Hi guys, I've had quite a busy day, as you can see. I've put the PlayStation 2 and 1 games all over here, and there's over 60 PS2 games there, in case anyone's wondering, and over 50 PS... No, I got that wrong. Over 60 PS2 games. I might have said PS1, I don't know. But anyway, and over 50 PS1 games. I've got the Spectrum on here. The only problem is I don't have an aerial cable, because it needs a funny one, which I'm sure I could probably find on eBay or something like that. Doubt I'll find it in any shop here. It's basically got to have an end like this on it, with that, to go in the back of the unit itself. And a standard aerial connector to go in the back of the TV on the other end. And I don't have one. And I did have to rewire the plug, because some tit had wired the plug on themselves, and they'd left like that much copper hanging out of each, so there was a short hazard in there. It's got the wrong size fuse in, because I have read it in the user guide, wherever I threw that, down there. It is meant to have a 3-amp fuse in it, and it's got a 13 in it, so I'm going to change that, so it's actually got the correct fuse in. But that is the reason why I check plugs on any second-hand electrical item I buy, because you never know if someone's damaged the original plug and changed it themselves. You don't know if they've wired it correctly or done something they shouldn't have done or took a shortcut. So they didn't even put the wires under the cord grip, they went over, and part of the live contact was literally that far from the actual screw that holds the cover on. Because the live wire had got folded over the little plastic divider that sort of separates live and neutral in the plug, and it'd been squished there, so it's fairly close to the screw. So, yeah, some people might think I'm nuts to keep checking plugs whenever I get something like that, but I'd rather do that than risk blowing myself up. Or blowing the item up that I'm trying to plug in and check. Go away, bit tape. Postpone, because I can't be arsed right this minute. So I've done all that. I've also put the moped back together. I had to do that because it was being picked up this afternoon. So that's gone out of my way. I had a bit of a sort out in the shed while I was down there as well. There's a few more bits gone in the scrap pile. I think I'm actually going to get Ruthers and chuck out quite a lot of bicycle parts, because I don't need them all. If I don't chuck them out, they'll probably get stuck on eBay and see if I can get a pound for them. I don't know, something or other. Whatever I decide to try and sell. Or I could give it away. I've just got too much of it, and the clutter is doing my nut in now. But, all is good. Oh, I'm going to bring eBay up for a couple of reasons. And what was I wanted up? Oh, yeah. Emails to see if that money's gone into my bank yet. No, unless it's gone into a spam folder, which wouldn't surprise me. No. I may not have got the email yet, but... you check PayPal. Logging in. Ooh, Betty Swallocks has got not paying 50 quid for that. More details. We'll go with Betty Swallocks has they've put 5 items up apparently. I want some more foldable signs. Foldable cones would be nice, but folding traffic cones. Not bad price for a pack of 4 from the look of it, with carry cases. I don't know if the police still do, but they used to use those because they're quite compact and easy to put in a car. I'm gonna add it to watch list. I think they're worth the note. The transfer to bank is still pending. That doesn't matter. I'm not going to, actually I will. Just because it hasn't registered on PayPal doesn't mean I haven't registered in the bank, so shouldn't be long, actually, because I should have gone in at some point this evening. I'm going to show you what I'm watching on eBay. In a minute. Clicking continue would help. Nope, hasn't gone in. Not yet. Can do that. Let's just go to my eBay. Watch these. There's 1 day and 13 hours left. 99p start bid, no one's bid. £8 postage, which is actually pretty cheap for those two. I'd only want one though. I'd only want the one on the right. That one. That one may end up just being stripped for any spare parts because it might repay. Oh, dearie me. It just looks rather worse for wear. And the paint on that one don't look too bad. It looks like it just needs a clean. Yeah, that one definitely has seen better days. And the hook is bent as well. Which isn't a problem, that can be straightened up fine. Although I may not even be able to get them. I can't bid too high. Not bidding yet. Anyway, that's what I'm watching in my eBay at the minute. Mainly because they're cheap. Have a quick look at all selling while I'm here. No, nothing different. Just the same 6 items. My cars have got £2 bid each on them. I bought 6 for £10. I've put 5 up on eBay because I've kept the fire truck up there. And I've made £10 back already because all 5 have got a bid on. 100% positive feedback. Oh, God, Nick, stop yawning. Right, when I'm done being Dolly Daydream, I didn't even realise the time was getting that late. It's actually 9:20. Anyway, I'm now able to get all the bikes in the shed. I smell something funny. Got that to build. I went and got that with the, or with part of the money I got from selling the moped, and a couple of rolls of PVC electrical tape because I was completely out. That is useful stuff to keep around. Oh, for Pete's sake, I knew I went on eBay to look for something. I want to look for one of them cables, didn't I? Search. Let's just put spectrum aerial cable. I don't think spectrum would have been the only thing to use that, would it? Well, there we go, £2.49. Well, that's from Hong Kong. I don't want five. Jesus. £6.99 is not a bad price, but I don't want five. Oh, there's one. £0.99 and £1.91 postage. I do actually have the cash to get that. But just enough sitting in my bank to get it. Well, it certainly looks like the correct cable. Brand new RF lead, length is 2 meter and colour is black, for use with N64, SNES, Mega Drive, Atari 2600, 7800, ST, STE, etc. ROHS standard compliant from a genuine UK seller. He's got more than one available, so I'm going to actually add that. He's got 10 available. So let's add that to watch list. See, I guarantee that would probably work on what I want it for as well. That looked like Ooh, lots of adapters and things. Well, that does look like that's the only option I've got. Unless I get the one from Hong Kong. Which is exactly the bloody same. Well, there's another one here. Sinclair, Spectrum, Commodore, RF TV cable. Aerial lead and SNES Sega Mega Drive. Actually, I could buy a couple at that price. No, I can't because I haven't quite got enough in the bank. But no, I don't have anything in PayPal spare. You know what? It's in my watch list. I'll leave it till Monday. Yeah, leave it till Monday. Or at least maybe Sunday. I wouldn't get posted till Monday now anyway, even if I did buy it, so... Now, give me a chance just to see exactly what spare change I have, and then I can hopefully get at least two. Because a spare one wouldn't be a bad thing, would it? You know, if I get another old machine like that, then I may need another one, so... Just an ask that I don't actually have one. At least the one in the back of the Mega Drive does work. It says it on there. It's a pity I didn't have a SNES, because that would have worked. It's the same cable. I suppose it's what they did back then, all used the same cable. There for a second. It is! Wasn't that wonderful? You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to treat us. I'm going to just pull the aerial cable out for a minute. And take it up here and plug it in. Plug it into the spectrum. And like so. And at least this way we'll know if the spectrum works. Oh, it's not going to work because I can't plug out of the bloody back of the TV. I've got it in a splitter at the minute, so I don't know how well the signal's going to be. How good the signal is going to be. Because, I know from experience... That epoxy splitter things, if you can see it in the back somewhere there. Never were very brilliant for signal. I think you actually have to turn that on and off at the mains, because there's no switch. It's doing something. I can't remember what channel I had the Amstrad on this. Ooh. It is actually working. Badly, but working. I think I may need the other piece of shit to do some tuning. No, I'm not, because apparently a fellow... Well, at least I can see something on there, so I know it does work. That's a good thing. That's all I want to know. So what I'll do, I'll get one of those cables, or a couple of them, and, or unplug the spectrum, actually, because I've got that proper fuse I need to put in there. And then I can set it up properly. Plug that back in at the back of the Megala Drive. Alright, so that's the cable I definitely need. It's a shame I couldn't butcher this and make this into one, but for the sake of 99p, I might as well go and buy one. £1 something postage. I assume the seller will have combined shipping on that, so... That's why I want to get a couple, at least. Because like I said, I've then got a spare one for the Mega Drive or the Spectrum. But, yeah, that's made me happy. At least I know it works. No on-off switch on it. That's the user guide. That's got to stay with that. I might have a read through that later. Couldn't do that again if I tried. Look at that, where that landed on there. Got to clean all that up. Oh. My cable got. I did go through this and get rid of a load of odd cable the other day when I was in one of my pissed off shitty moods. It's not a bad thing when I'm in them moods, you know, because I do have a clear air. I think I chopped up about 6 SCART leads and I've still got all these SCART leads in here. I don't know why I had so many, to be honest. Usually because when friends and family say, do you want, I say yes, even if I don't really need it. Yeah. And I might as well just go straight in the bin. I've given all the cable to Biggles to weigh in. and gave me those PlayStation 2 games in return. So, that's all that done. Good. That's in place. I'm happy. I'm a happy chap. Just need to put a 3-amp fuse in there, which is up here. That's another thing for the Amstrad. That's awesome. I've got two working retro computers. I'm not looking to create a gigantic, huge collection, but I'm just going to buy them if I get the opportunity, like I had for these two. The Spectrum was cheap, and the Amstrad just came along from the right person, so I thought I had, I'd left a disc in there. Dipstick. Not going to do that, not good, is it? Right, so I'm just going to stick this 3-amp fuse into this plug, which I can't show you because the amp lead's too short. It's covered under all the other cables. A lot of spaghetti junction under here. I really need to perhaps go behind this with some cable ties or something and just tidy all these cables up. Or at least pair them up or whatever to the right machine so I know which goes where. That would be a help as well. Right, there we go. Screw the plug back up and we have now got the correct in. I thought that would be a 3-amp fuse because I looked at that and the max output is 1.4 amp. So I thought, well, the 13 amp in it must be far too big. It'll work. If anything went faulty, it wouldn't pop. That's why I've just changed it for the correct fuse. Two Mega Drive controllers. Like so. Again, you know, same with old consoles. If anything ever came along, like GameCube cheap or something, and I've got the money at the time, I'll probably grab it, but I'm not actively looking for them, if you know what I mean. It's just something I'll add to the collection as and when. Well, I think I've got quite a nice little retro collection down here. Complete with CRT TV. If I can find an older TV, that would be perfect. I've got a TV-DVD combo out in the outside cupboard, which part of me wants to throw away, because I'm in one of those throw-away moods, or selling moods, depending on if the item is actually worth selling or not. But I think I'd better keep that as a spare. I think that is something I would actually regret. Something like this rusty old seat post, I don't know why I kept it in the first place, so bin, all the scrap pile out front for my scrap man to take. I'm not fussed which. I just want it out of my friggin' way. Put a 13 amp in there. I don't know why, because I don't really need it. I could have thrown it in the bin. Cool. It's got a sticky enter key on that, though. That's one of the issues with that Spectrum. The enter key sticks, but I did look on eBay, and I didn't find a ZX Spectrum Plus on there for less than £20, so I think I got a good deal. Because if I'd bought it on eBay, I'd have had the postage to stick on top of that as well. So it would have actually cost me a lot more. I think the cheapest I found on eBay was just over £20, sort of £24 or something. Oh well. Got my nice little collection going. Scrap trailer needs emptying, but that probably won't happen till next week now. Right. Last job I need to do is make some room up here. That's where I'm going to build. I don't want to one goes there. This one there, put my tool tray back in the toolbox. Close the lid. No, there's no way I'm going to pick that up. I need two hands. I do wish I'd hang my coats up when I'm done and not chuck them on the floor. Go through those and see if they're worth donating or throwing in the bin. If the discs are too damaged, then I'll just chuck them in the bin. Keep the cases, because I like the green cases. I'll keep those, but everything else can go in the bin. Right. I've nearly got enough room. Once I've cleared enough room, I'm going to shut the camera down. I've got an acid left in there. I must get some of those when that cash goes into my bank. Rubbish. Oh, no. Need to keep that. That's rubbish, though. Sorry, neighbour. I forget sometimes how much of a clunk that lid make when I let go of it. Anyway. The work light's on. Tub there on the move. Well, I haven't done anything to this today. It's pretty good, isn't it? Because you can't see any of the electric cables I used to wire the lights up with. Because I hid them really well. That depends what angle you're standing at, because at a certain angle you can see one, or maybe it's coming up on camera, just behind the cafe there, that the camera's pointed at, right at the back. But I think that is actually the only one you can see. Yeah, because, well, apart from that one hanging out the back there, but considering visitors are going to be mostly standing at this sort of angle, there's a lot they're not going to see, you see. That's the whole idea of it. I didn't want the wires showing. That's the one I want to light next. I haven't figured out how I'm going to hide the cable yet, though. I can wire it straight to that one. But as I said, I haven't quite figured out how or where I'm going to hide the cable. Well, that's a tricky one. There is a gap between these boards where they go together, and the wires are thin enough to go through that gap. When I can find the bulb that I actually want. I did get it stuck around the G-Tech the other day, but I pulled it out and it was still usable. Oh, I'll find it when I want it. Anyway, that is it for this video. So, as always, if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't already for more daily videos, and that is it. So I'll talk to you again in the next video. Bye.